So I wanted to do a quick recording, show where I am with this prototype, talk about a few of the things I'm internally happy about. So you'll notice in the top right a little chittering avatar just saying something random at the moment. And the intention is to have that all blacked out at the top and bring the game window down and in. I'm not entirely sure I'm happy with that, or I should just ditch it and not try and have some flimsy story attached to what is just a shooter. Anyway, one of the other things I've added is little particle effects come off buildings when you hit them, and same part effects come off the enemies when you hit them, and they are hittable now. When they die, they change their physics model and fall to the ground. That's when they impact another real-world object, is when they finally trigger their explosion. Does lead to some amusing interactions. Ah, and that's maybe I can make that achievement, play Keep You Up for 12 seconds or something. The green bar on the top is going to be the health eventually. It's not wired in yet. The red bar is a heat system. When it hits maximum, you can no longer fire. Still playing around with what values actually want in there for that. Just reset the game. I haven't got a way to do that with them relaunching at the moment. Put a few more objects into the scenery. Actually fly through them to a degree. You might need to raise the camera a little. Don't want that much dead space at the bottom necessarily. And of course, the last thing is the skull cancer is going up there. That's not the last thing. The other thing is that so I created a class to hold description of a movement. And then the spawn manager, which is an invisible object off the screen, assigns each enemy that's spawned with a dictionary data type that holds a list of these movement class instances. So the first one is to go left and right in a curve. Then go up another curve, and then go straight left. You can see where they speed up. That's where they run out of instructions, and they take their default instruction of go left at a speed. So I need to do a bit more work on classifying that, wrapping it up neatly. Hopefully, that'll give me a way to describe motions for enemies in a simple, repeatable way. That's it for this video. Let me know what you think of the chittering girl at the top. Think about making her react and get angry when ships die or you take damage, stuff like this. At the moment, she just moves her mouth in line with what text has been populated into the box.